There are several ways of depicting fluid power systems. A picture of any component will help locating it in a system. The picture of a power unit can be helpful in recognizing the orientation of the various components. A cutaway image can be useful when explaining the function of a component. However, none of these will fully explain the interrelation of the parts nor the actual application of the circuit. For this, a circuit diagram or schematic composed of symbols is necessary. Symbols represent the universal language of the fluid power industry. It is the use of these symbols that allow anyone familiar with them to read and understand a fluid power circuit, no matter their native language. The ability to read and interpret a circuit diagram is vital to anyone involved in the transfer of energy through fluid, be it hydraulic or pneumatic, industrial or mobile. The symbols that represent components within a fluid power circuit diagram are made up of a combination of images. Learning these images is much like learning the alphabet of a language. Once the images are understood, any symbol can be spelled out to reveal its meaning. Most of the images that make up the symbols are common among the branches of fluid power. Some symbols are exclusive to one branch or another, but the images that make up those symbols are common. Basic symbols. The following images do not represent the entire list of possible images. They do represent the ones that are most useful in recognizing and describing common hydraulic circuits. Flow line. This image simply shows that there is a conductor in which the fluid will travel. It does not indicate size, material, or direction. Dash line. This image indicates either a pilot line or a drain line, depending on its termination points. If it connects two devices, it's a pilot line. If it terminates in a reservoir or is open to atmosphere, it is a drain or vent. Frame. Different style lines create a frame for multiple components. It can consist of a dash dotted lines, which represents a grouping of discrete components into an assembly, a solid line, which represents component with linked functions. Flow line connections. It is important to be able to recognize the relationship of flow lines in a circuit. Flow lines are connected as indicated by the dot at the intersection point. They may also cross without being connected. This would be indicated without a dot. Crossing lines can sometimes be confused with connected lines, so be sure to determine the difference. Some historical schematics may be drawn with an arc around the crossed flow line, but this no longer meets the ISO specification. Arrow. An arrow indicates the intended direction of flow. It does not indicate whether the flow is hydraulic or pneumatic. Arrow at an angle. An angled arrow passing through another symbol indicates the capability of adjustment or that the component is variable. Solid triangle. An isosceles triangle that is filled in indicates a hydraulic energy source and also the direction of the energy flow. Empty triangle. An isosceles triangle that is not filled in indicates a pneumatic energy source and also the direction of energy flow. Open rectangle. This image indicates a reservoir that is open to atmosphere. It may be shown in different sizes to accommodate a circuit. The size of the symbol does not indicate the capacity of the reservoir. Note, in order to simplify a schematic drawing, the convention is that any return connection back to the reservoir terminates using the open rectangle or reservoir symbol. While there may be several reservoir symbols indicated, there is only one reservoir. Closed rectangle. This image indicates a reservoir that is pressurized. It may be shown in different sizes to accommodate a circuit. The size of the symbol does not indicate the capacity of the reservoir.